Hello friends, welcome to SQL practical question series. So here is another interesting question. So the question is, we are given with a range of values, and based on the range we need to print the sequence of numbers. For example, so here is the start range and end range. It's from 1 to 3, so we need to print from 1 till 3. Same way, the next range is from 5 to 5, we need to print the 5. The next range is 7 to 9, we need to print from 7 to 9. So this is the expectation. In fact, in the previous video, we just saw exactly the reverse of the condition. For example, we are provided with the sequence and we need to find out the starting and ending range. For example, in this case 1, 2, 3, we are just printing like start range is 1 and end range is 3. Then comes the next group, that is 5. So we are just printing. I would suggest you to watch through the previous video for a better understanding. In fact, this is the scenario what we saw in the previous video. But in this video, we are just going to see exactly the reverse of this scenario. We are provided with the range, and for that particular range, we need to print the sequence. So in this video, I'm just going to show you two different methods by which we are going to achieve this functionality. Okay, let us start with the first method of implementation. So this is a very simple and straightforward method. What I'm going to do is, along with the input table, I'm going to write a SQL which prints the sequence number till the maximum value present in this table. For example, in this case, the maximum value is 20. So I'm just going to write a SQL which prints from 1 to 20. Now that we have two data, one is, let us say this is like T1 and the sequence numbers is like T2 table. So we are just going to join T1 and T2 such a way that the value from here should be present within this range of T1. So in this case, like 1 and 3 present within the start range and range. So these are eligible for printing. The next 4, when you check the 4 will not present in any of the boundary conditions given here. So you should not print the 4. So next comes the 5. 5 exists between the second group here. So that is that we need to print. Similarly, 6 is also not part of any group. So we should not print the 6. So 7 present within this group. So we are going to join T1 and T2 such a way that we are going to check whether the sequence number fits in the given range of data. I'll show you the query. I will write the query later, but I will just show you the query for a better understanding. So this is the query I'm just going to show you in a demo in a while. But the key thing is it's based on two inline query. The first inline query is basically to get the data from T1 table or let's say T table. The second inline query is basically to print the list of numbers like this. So I'm just going to join. The very key learning here is that the condition of, that is the join condition. So I'm just checking the sequence number should be greater than the start range and end, and it should be less than the end range. Otherwise we can say the sequence number should be between the range, that is it should be between start range and end range. Fine. I hope now you would have got a little bit idea. Now let me show you the query so that you'll be able to understand better. Okay, I'm just creating the table. The table is created. Let me populate with our test data. The data are populated. I'm just committing the data. Fine. Let us first query the information. Yes, this is our given range of data. Now let us select the maximum value of end range. Okay, from T. So this is our maximum value. So we just need to print a sequence starting from 1 till 20. For that, I'm going to write select star from dual connect by level less than or equal to, instead of hard coded value, I'm just using this as our inline view here. So instead of star, let me use a row name. So you can use either row name or level pseudo column. Now, if you see, the second query is actually printing from 1 to 20. Fine. Now we have like two result set. One is from the range from the given input table, and second is a sequence. Now let us just join both these things. So I'm saying select star from, let me make this as, let's give an alias like T1 comma, let me make this as T2 Okay, so the key learning here is the join condition where t2 dot r greater than or equal to start range and t2 dot r less than or equal to end range. That's it. Okay, so either you can write it like this, otherwise to make it even simpler we can say r between start range and end range. So both are exactly the same. Okay. Yeah, both are exactly the same. So the key learning here is that how we are joining the given range data and the sequence data. This is our first method of implementation. Now let me show you the second method of implementation. The second method of implementation is little bit different from the first method. Okay, first let me show you what the logic I'm going to follow for the second method. So in the second method, what I'm going to do, first I'm going to compute the number of values within each boundary range. For example, within 1 and 3, there are 3 numbers. Similarly, from 5 to 5, there is 1 number. 7 to 9, there are 3 numbers. So that we are going to compute. So that is nothing but we are subtracting the end range minus start range plus 1. For example, 3 minus 1 plus 1. So we will get the number of elements or number of sequence values, or we can say simply number of numbers present in that range. For example, from 15 to 16, there will be like 2 numbers, that is 15 and 16. Now what I am going to do, I am just going to replicate the given data, the number of value times. For example, 1 and 3, we need to replicate 3 times. Okay, so 1 and 3, I am going to replicate 3 times. And I'm putting one more sequence like 0, 1, 2. Same way 5, there is only one element. So I'm just going to replicate the 5 only one time. 7 to 9 is 3 numbers. So we are just going to replicate 3 times. 7 to 9 with the sequence number like 0, 1, 2. Okay. Now if you see, you just take the start. Anyway, end range is not needed. Just for understanding only, I just printed it here. We'll take the start range and sequence number. We'll just do a summation. Like 1 plus 0, it returns 1. 1 plus 1 returns 2 here. Same way 1 plus 2 returns 3. You can take anything. For example, let's take the 11 group. 11 plus 0 will return 11. 11 plus 1 will return 12. Okay. So this is the logic I'm just going to follow for the second method of implementation. Now let me show you the query. I hope now it would be easy for you to understand the query while I'm writing. Okay, let us start from the start range and end range. So what I'm going to do, I'm just going to first find the number of elements that are going to be present within each range. So let me put end range minus start range. Let me put 1. Okay, so you can see here the number of values between 1 and 3 is 3. So within 5 and 5 is 1. 7 and 9 is 3 numbers. Okay, now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to use a lateral join. Lateral select row name, let me give alias r from dual connect by level less than or equal to, instead of hard coded range, I'm just going to use the computed value here. Now let me execute the query. Now if you see, 1, 3 range is replicated 3 times, 5 is printed 1 time, 7 to 9 is printed 3 times. Similarly, 11 to 12 is printed 2 times because only two numbers exist between 11 and 12. Fine. Now what I'm going to do, I'm just going to print the R, that is from the inner subquery. Let me put minus 1 because I need the sequence from 0, starting from 0. For each group, if you see, we got a individual sequence 0, 1 and 2. For the next group, since it is only one value, we just got the 0. Same way for 7 to 9, we just got 0, 1, 2. Okay. Now, anyway, I'm not interested in the rest of the column. So let me remove the other column, whatever I'm not interested in. Okay. So I just took only the start range, end range, and the sequence. Now, what I'm just going to do, I'm just going to take the start range plus whatever the sequence number. That's it. Now we got the expected sequence. Whatever the column you are not interested in, you can just remove it from the select class. Okay, so this is our result. Okay, So these are the two methods of implementation. In fact, I have received in the comment section from one of the subscriber a completely different method of implementation here using only the connect by class. Okay, in fact, I posted that, I copied and posted that query in the blog link for everyone's understanding. In fact, all these queries along with the query whatever I have received in the comment section, I have posted in the blog link. I would suggest you can watch, you can go and take these queries and you can understand easily now. Okay. So here is a question for you. In fact, this question I have received from one of the subscriber, and in fact, I have posted the earlier two videos, including this video, basically to explain this particular scenario only, because after understanding this video and the previous video, it is very much easy for you to solve this question. First, let me explain what is the expected output here. So we are given a table called cars. It contains like three columns: the name of the car, start year and end year. So in this case, like name is Swift, starting from 2007 to 2009, same way, then 2009 to 2011, then 2011 to 2013. That is, it is continuous from 2007 to 2013. So we just need to print in the output Swift starting from 2007 to 2013. Same way, let us take the next group, Maruti. It is starting from 2007 to 2011, whereas the next set starts from 2013. So there is a discontinuity between 2011 and 2012. So we need to print both these groups, one for 2009 to 2011 and another for 2013 to 2015. I will explain in the next video. However, if you are able to understand these two questions in detail, I know you'll be able to solve this problem. If it was solved, just post your queries in the comment section. I will explain how to solve this in the next video. I hope you have learned something new today. If yes, please like this video, subscribe and stay tuned for new feature video, interview question, SQL practical question and concept videos. And if you want any questions to be answered, you can post it in the comment section or you can drop to this mail ID. And thanks a lot for watching this video.